Yeah, I would like to say about this situation because I think the imprisonment of Dr. Anand Tamuldre and Gautam Nalakka and other activists is not constitutional because you cannot force someone by pressing wrong charges of linking to Maoist or something like this. If they are saying something which is it's old tradition, when somebody want to stop someone from the freedom of the speech, they use false allegation. So that's why I would like to demand the immediate release of Dr. Anand, Gautam Nalakka, and other human rights activists. And I would like to say that the investigation should be expedited, and so it should be done quickly rather than putting them baselessly on the baseless charges they are being there. Thank you very much.
India Civil Watch USA condemns the imprisonment of Anand Tildumbe and Gautam Nawlakha on April 14, 2020. We also continue to condemn the arrest of nine others in the same fabricated Bhima Koregaon case: Surinder Gadling, Arun Ferreira, Vernon Gonsalves, Mahesh Raut, Sudha Bharadwaj, Soma Sen, Sudhir Dhawale, Rona Wilson, and Varwar Rao. We further condemn the most recent spate of arrests of students such as Safura Zargar, Devangana Kalita, and Natasha Narwal. This national shame has now also become a colossal tragedy for democracy in India. For example, the Bhima Koregaon 11 have spent many decades defending India's millions who live in abject poverty and vulnerable to all forms of stigma and violence. They have fought all their lives for the freedoms that are enshrined in the Indian Constitution. And the students who now join them in prison are some of the finest examples of young citizens who dare to preserve what is central to all democracies, the right to dissent. Their work and lives bear testimony against the immorality and systemic and situational violence perpetrated in India today. The violence of development policies, violence of casteism against Dalits and Adivasis, violence against religious minorities, the violence of patriarchy against women, the violence of capitalism against workers, the violence of educational institutions against freedom of thought, and the violence of an ultra-nationalism against those seeking a life of freedom and choice. If this is not enough, all of those arrested face the ravages of COVID-19, which has fast spread within Indian jails. Many of them are extremely vulnerable due to age and pre-existing conditions. What does it then mean for a country to put such individuals in jail and to leave them intentionally exposed to COVID virus in the jails? What else is this but intellectual bankruptcy, moral degeneracy, and political repression of citizens demanding social justice and sound governance? What else is it but a textbook ploy by a repressive regime spiraling into a fascist rule? We, the international communities that oppose fascism, will never cease to fight for the release of people who have been denied their basic constitutional rights, booked under fabricated cases such as Bhima Koregaon, aided by laws such as UIPA, now widely recognized by vast cross-sections of Indian and international scholarly and legal community and public opinion as inherently draconian. We urge the international social justice communities to take immediate urgent note of India's rapid descent into fascist rule and to defend democracy and the rule of justice. Jai Bhim.
Better, thanks. This national shame has now also become a colossal tragedy for democracy in India. For example, the Bhima Koregaon 11 have spent many decades defending India's millions who live in abject poverty and vulnerable to all forms of stigma and violence. And the students who now join them in prison are some of the finest examples of young citizens who dare to preserve what is central to all democracies, the right to dissent. Their work and lives bear testimony against the immorality of the systemic and situational violence perpetrated in India today. The violence of development politics, development policies, violence of casteism against Dalits and Adivasis, violence against religious minorities, and the violence of patriarchy against women, the violence of capitalism against workers, the violence of educational institutions against freedom of thought, and the violence of an ultra-nationalism against those seeking a life of freedom of thought, and the violence of an ultra-nationalism against those seeking a life of freedom and choice. If this is not enough, all of those arrested face the ravages of COVID-19, which has fast spread within Indian jails. Many of them are extremely vulnerable due to age and pre-existing conditions. What does this then mean for a country to put such individuals in jail and to leave them intentionally exposed to COVID-19 virus in the jails? What else is this but intellectual bankruptcy, moral degeneracy, and political repression of citizens demanding social justice and sound governance? What else is it but a textbook play by a repressive regime spiraling into a fascist rule? We, the international communities that oppose fascism, will never cease to fight for the release of people who have been denied their basic constitutional rights, booked under fabricated cases such as Bhima Koregaon, aided by laws such as the UAPA, now widely recognized by a vast cross-section of Indian and international social justice communities by a vast cross-section of Indian international scholarly and legal community and public opinion as inherently draconian. We urge the international social justice communities to take immediate and urgent note of India's rapid descent into fascist rule and to defend democracy and the rule of justice.
And the first thing I wanted to mention is this whole controversy, so-called controversy of Arpan Naxal and Bhima Koregaon Yelgar case has been started in 2018. Basically, when Yelgar Parishad happened on 31st December 2017 at Shanivar Wada at Pune. Why I'm saying this is because we are the organization, along with another 250 organizations in Maharashtra who are progressive, Ambedkarites, socialist, democratic, came together to organize Yelgar Parishad. And we have organized it to clearly oppose the fascist government, the Brahminical fascism, which is raising in India, and also to oppose BJP's basically authoritarian rule. And we were saying this clearly, we were saying this openly. Also in Yelgar Parishad, we also took oath saying that we are opposing this unconstitutional and authoritative government. Also, we are opposing all undemocratic forces, violent forces. And we stood by values of Indian constitution. And we are not going to vote BJP for our end of our life, for a lifetime. And this was the oath which we have taken on 31st of December. After that, on 1st of January, we know the world has seen how Bhide and Egbote attacked in Bhima Koregaon. And after that, when the struggle started, we all the organizations, social, democratic, Ambedkarite organizations came together. And we have collected enough proof to present Maharashtra government, and we have presented that. So we have each and every proof that how Bhide and Egbote have done these attacks, and we have presented to the Chief Minister of then Chief Minister Mr. Devendra Phadnavis at that time. But what happened is, as their state, their government is everything is in their hands. So though we have these proofs and all these things, they have completely turned up. Hello? Hello?
I can hear you. Continue.
Yeah. So they have completely turned up this theory, and they have completely turned up and, keeping aside these proofs, they have arrested our people. And out of 11, those who have arrested, out of 11, only one person, that is Sudhir Dhavale, who is from our organization called Republican Panthers Caste and Deletion Movement. He was the only one who was there to organize Yelgar Parishad. None of the 11 activists, none of them were there. Of course, all these people are working for the democratic rights and Hello.
Yeah, we can hear you.
Continue.
So the thing is that now the situation is, no one is ready to hear what we have. apart from that, they have appointed one commission called Bhima Koregaon Commission, headed by Justice J.N. Patel. And this commission is total farce because, Harshali Poddar, they have lodged one complaint on 8th of January 2018, the first complaint which they have lodged. We were six of us on whom they have lodged this complaint, along with Sudhir and five of us. So, to conspire this Bhima Koregaon or to conspire basically about how Naxals are involved in the organizing Yelkar Parishad and all these things, crap, they have mentioned in that FIR. And this was a private FIR, private individual lodged this FIR. And police and state come says that along, because of this FIR, they have started investigation, and after in this investigation, they have found the Naxal names. So this FIR was lodged on 8th of January 2018. After that, basically, we were moved ahead. We have collected all the proofs against BD and Ekbote. We have presented that, and after that, in April 2018, already we have presented this proof to the Chief Minister of Maharashtra, then Chief Minister Devendra Phadnavis, and after that, on 17th of April 2018, when they got it that these people are not going to stop, and these people are we were pushing them to investigate on that line. So their line of inquiry should be, towards the BDA and Ekbote. So instead of that, they have raided our houses on 17th of April, our offices on 17th of April, 2018. And after that, basically, on 6th of June, they have arrested five of these people, Sudhir, Shoma, Mahesh, and Rona. They have arrested and Surendra, Advocate Surendra Gadli. So basically, from then, this theory, they have started this counter theory called Urban Naxal, which is completely false. Still we have, when they formed this commission, Bhima Koregaon riot commission, headed by Justice J.N. Patel, we went there. We also submitted, I have submitted my affidavit over there, stating all the proofs. Saying that how BDA and Ekbote done this conspiracy and how they attacked. We have provided all the Facebook screenshots, their mobilization tactics, how they have mobilized 2 days before Bhima Koregaon. They have started all this conspiracy from November of 2017, September, October, November 2017, and successfully they have mobilized everyone along their Hindutva programmatical forces. And they were clearly, warned on Facebook, social media, on each and every platform of social media, saying that we are going to attack. Even they were posted on Facebook saying that, claiming that we are demolished this Bhima Koregaon statue, alike Babri Masjid, which we have demolished in 1992. So basically, they have clearly there was a clear conspiracy of BDA and Ekbote, and these all proofs we have submitted to government in the commission also. But I don't think, we really don't have any hope from this government that they are going to take any action, as we are seeing that BDA and Ekbote are basically roaming free around. These Brahminical terrorists are roaming around, free around. And our people are now behind the bars. So basically, this initiative from all the international platforms, I guess this is a very good initiative. And now what we are expecting is, a lot of support from political, maybe it is political, maybe it is social, but this social movement should stood up now to speak up. Because in India, the situation is very bad. Not bad, I'll say it is worse. So UAPA is like a tool to what do you call, suppress the voice of Democratic and Ambedkarite and everyone who are talking against the government, against the illegal and policies of government. So UAPA is the simple tool for them to crush the voices. So I again congratulate. I'm not going to take much time, but I'll conclude here. I'll get a chance, I'll try to send whatever documents I have regarding the attacks happened in Bhima Koregaon in 2018, done by Bhide and Ekbote. So this truth and this should be come out. So that's it. And on 6th of June, yeah, one more thing. On 6th of June 22 years will be completed for all of five activists which arrested on 6th of June 2018. So 2 years will be completed on this 6th June. So if we can do something on this 6th June, so it will be really great. As we have done this protest today, or as we have conduct this meeting today, so we can do something on 6th June. And all those who have supported and now read the solidarity statement, I'll insist that if this statement come in writing and we can circulate here, we can, because there will be a great support from India also if international fraternity they'll realize that this kind of protest is happening all around the world, then we will also be able to go to people and convince them for stood for this cause. So thanks a lot, Jai Bhim, to all of you.
Thanks. Yeah, Jai Bhim to all. I'm Ragini Meshram from Pune. I would like to express over here that it's a very sad incident happened where Dr. Anand Teltumbe and the other activists were arrested and maybe purposely on 14th April. So I like to voice to the government of India to release them as soon as possible. And I also thanks all the organizers for taking the efforts for taking this initiative. That's it from my side.
Thank you, Ragini. Thank you.
I strongly condemn the arrest of Dr. Anand Teltumbe and I urge government to release him without any condition and all human rights activities immediately. Thanks to all of you.
Thank you, Chandra.
Yeah, no problem. Hey, this is Madhi from Dallas, Texas State. So unfortunately, we have been ruled by the fascist and hatred government. Last 5 years, there is a huge increase in hatred and polarization. And there is a huge, lot of unconstitutional arrests have been going on and a lot of activists have been put in behind bars. So I immediately demand the release of all the human activists who got arrested and also the BK-12. So thanks for the initiative, Karthik and AKSC.
First of all, I would like to thank everyone for coming forward to integrate all the international community and to speak for the arrest of Anand Teltumbe and all the other activities who are part of the Bhima Koregaon. The way the Anand Teltumbe was arrested, that is just before Dr. Ambedkar's birthday, shows the fascist nature of the government and the grudge they have on the Dalit and oppressed community and all the Ambedkarists all over India. And it is like a black spot on Indian democracy that was just before his birthday. So we as an international community, we extend our support and we want to show our solidarity with Anand Teltumbe and all the other activists who were arrested and were part of the Anand Bhima Koregaon. We as part of the international community, we demand the immediate release of the activist and writer Anand Teltumbe. Thank you again, Magesh and AKAC for bringing everybody together. Thank you. That's it, Magesh.
Jai Bhim, my name is Raghav. I'm from Kirkland, Washington in USA. I would like to condemn the arrest of Anand Teltumbe and demand his immediate release, along with the other activists collectively known as the Bhima Koregaon 12. Instead, the government should be going after the real culprits, which is the Hindutva criminals like Bhide and Igbote. Jai Bhim, thank you.
Thank you.
So all I want to say is to all our friends and comrades in AKSC, in AIC, and in the Coalition of Seattle Indian Americans, who are the other co-sponsors of this event, thank you so much for organizing this. We will all remain, as Harshali said earlier, we all need to fight this together, and we'll all fight this battle for democracy in India together. Much love, much solidarity. Jai Bhim, Lal Salaam. Thank you.
I will read the statement. This is Raja from India Civil Watch. Thank you very much for organizing this. Lal Salaam, Jai Bhim to all comrades in the group right now. I will read out the same statement that my comrades read earlier. India Civil Watch. India Civil Watch USA condemns the imprisonment of Anand Teltumbe and Gautam Nawalkar on April 14th, 2020. We also continue to condemn the arrest of 9 others in the same fabricated Bhima Koregaon case: Surendra Gadling, Arun Ferreira, Vernon Gonzalez, Mahesh Raut, Sudha Bharadwaj, Shoma Sen, Sudhir Davale, Rona Wilson, and Varavara Rao. We further condemn the most recent spate of arrests of students such as Safura Zargar, Devangana Kalita, and Natasha Narwal. The national shame has now also become a colossal tragedy for democracy in India. For example, the Bhima Koregaon 11 have spent many decades defending India's millions who live in abject poverty and vulnerable to all forms of stigma and violence. They have fought all their lives for the freedoms that are enshrined in the Indian Constitution. And the students who now join them in prison are some of the finest examples of young citizens who dare to preserve what is central to all democracies, the right to dissent. Their work and lives bear testimony against the immorality of the systemic and situational violence perpetrated in India today, the violence of development policies, violence of casteism against Dalits and Adivasis, violence against religious minorities, violence of patriarchy against women, and the violence of capitalism against workers, the violence of educational institutions against freedom of thought, and the violence of the ultranationalism against those seeking a life of freedom and choice. If this is not enough, all of those arrested face the ravages of COVID-19, which has fast spread within Indian jails. Many of them are extremely vulnerable due to age and pre-existing conditions. What does it then mean for a country to put such individuals in jail and to leave them intentionally exposed to the COVID-19 virus in these jails? What else is this but intellectual bankruptcy, moral degeneracy, and political repression of citizens demanding social justice and sound governance? What else is it but a textbook ploy by a repressive regime spiraling into fascist rule? We, the international communities that oppose fascism, will never cease to fight for the release of people who have been denied their basic constitutional rights, booked under fabricated cases such as Bhima Koregaon, aided by laws such as UAPA, now widely recognized by a vast section, cross-section of Indian and international scholarly and legal community and public opinion as inherently draconian. We at India Civil Watch urge the international social justice communities to take immediate and urgent note of India's rapid descent into fascist rule and to defend democracy and the rule of justice. Jai Bhim, Lal Salaam.